Hello my lovely friends on YouTube. In this video, I'm going to be taking my Insta360 YX out for a walk to Casa Loma, which is a castle located in Toronto, Canada. I'm also going to be sharing my thoughts and experiences on this 360 camera, so this will be a vlog plus review kind of video. All of the footages shown in this video are shot before the pandemic. Well, I do have more recent footages from the camera. It is a lot more fun for me to make this vlog instead because for a strawberry-loving cat like myself, humans are sure interesting to look at and I haven't seen this many people in a really long time. And really quick, I just want to say that I bought this camera with my own money and I have nothing to do with Insta360. Anyways, without further ado, let's get started with the vlog and review. Just kidding! This is editor Minaki here to let you know that there is an Insta360 ONE X2 now, and for that reason, the Insta360 ONE X has been discontinued. But a lot of what I have said in this video regarding my experience with the camera is applicable to other small Insta360 cameras, like the Insta360 ONE X2. Okay, that's all. Now let's get started for real! Casa Loma, which is Spanish for Hell House, is the only real full-size castle in a North American city. It was built in the early 1900s by Sir Henry Pellet, who is known for his role in bringing hydroelectricity to Toronto for the first time. Today, Casa Loma is one of Toronto's top tourist attractions and hospitality venues. Oh, and it is also a popular filming location for movies and television. We have arrived at Casa Loma! There is a special culinary event today where we get to experience the elegance of the Edwardian era with an afternoon tea at the castle. And speaking of which, I am a little hungry now, so we're just gonna head straight to the dining area to sip tea and eat yummy food. The video quality is acceptable so far. It's really easy to film with this camera because it has built-in stabilization, so we don't need a gimbal, but at the same time, we're sacrificing quality for convenience here. For the afternoon tea, we had the pleasure of sampling lots of mini pastries including egg croissants, biscuits, scones, crumpets, and more. Everything is so mini, very cute. I like the tea that they offered. We could choose between Uncle Grey, which is a black tea with bergamot oil and a hint of vanilla, and Rooibos Chai, which is a caffeine-free red tea with chai spices, and Nourish the Soul, which is a Sencha green tea with orange, ginger, sunflower blossoms, lemon myrtle, and lemongrass. I also like how they put everything on a massive cake tower. After the delightful afternoon tea, we get to tour the castle. However, I've set the shutter speed to auto, which is a really bad idea because I don't think that the camera is really fast at detecting what shutter speed to use. If you're vlogging, do not use the auto shutter speed. I mean, I ended up with shots like this. I think the solution is to just manually set a higher shutter speed when you are in a low light condition. Because of this mistake, I ended up with a lot of blurred footages. But since this is a 360 camera, we can make several clips out of our usable footages and still make them look interesting. Another thing that is a bit inconvenient is that the battery will drain itself even when we turn off the camera. I heard that the battery drain is still happening in more recent Insta360 products such as the ONE R and the ONE X2. Even though the battery drain can be avoided by simply taking the battery out of the camera, I wish there is a way to prevent battery drain without taking the extra step. Overall, I really enjoyed the Casa Loma visit, and having a camera where we can just press a button and forget about it really helps add to this enjoyment. Thanks so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in future videos. Bye bye!